Hi Blender fans and welcome to Blender DC. In today's tutorial we're going to make this cube turn into a milk jug, so I'm just going to scale this in the Z by 2 just to actually give it a basic shape of our milk carton. And this one, in this tutorial, we're going to be covering some blocking out just to actually show you how you can quickly and easily make a milk jug in this case. So I've subdivided that by 2 along one edge and by 2 along the other edge. So, and what I'm going to do now is go on face select and we'll delete the center point. What we'll do is select the center point and move it forward and then subdivide it by 2 in that direction and control and R and 2 in the other direction. Go on face select and select the top faces with the box select by holding your left mouse button down. And then what we can do is we just press the X key and delete the top faces. And then all we're going to do is we're going to go on point select. Now we're going to select the four corners and we're just going to roughly shape these and make it into a circle like that, just by scaling it down simply. Now what we're doing is we're actually just using different points with the control key to actually join them up between them, and we're just actually shrinking things down. If I go on face select, I'm just gonna control and R just to actually make a subdivision in the center there, and using the control key mainly. What we're doing, we're on line select and we're just scaling down different faces of our jug just to make on jug or carton, whatever you want to call it. And we're just going to move that up into the air, and as you can see, this is a quite fiddly thing to do, and I'm just going on line select with the control keys and just joining these up. I'm just changing this and just basically blocking this out and making myself the jug shape. You scale this down on the X, pressing the S key down. So select that line, control, and select the other line at the far end, which actually joins all the lines up in between, and we just scale this in the X. And we'll just move this back a bit. There we are, and we're making our jug shape, and just move that down with G and Z. Select this top circle and extrude it with the E key. Just make the basic shape of our jug. I'm going on point select now, and we're selecting the corners, and I'm just going to move these back like that. As you can see, this is starting to take form, and this in under 12 minutes will be a jug. So I just move it back a bit more. Yeah, and you just keep re-evaluating it and moving it around just to actually make sure that the actual shape is the shape you want. And use the control key to actually join between points. Yeah, there we go. Let's have a look, just quick evaluation. I think it's coming along all right. I just scale that in the X, those 2 points, and we'll just move these with proportional editing, and I'm just going to scale these in the X, and I'm shrinking down the influence ring. And this will just help us to shape things just that little bit better. The top target is the influence ring. As you can see on the top line, you've got that blue square. And I'm just going to actually control and R just to actually subdivide that and take the points. And I'm just going to scale those down. As you can see, we're making the handle shape, and select the points there with the control keys, and select the other points. So we've now selected all those squares, and I'm just going to scale these down in the X direction. Like that. Go on face select, select that face and scale this down. E and S by 0.75. And E and S by 0.75 on the other side. And then what we'll do is actually select both these faces. And then right click to bridge between the two. Bridge faces. Like that. So basically we're making a jug shape. And select that face and just move it in slightly. Get the influence ring down just to actually make it thicker. And as you can see, very quickly and easily, we're actually making this shape start to work. Go on line select, press the Alt key and left click, and we're going to go on our press the Tab C to go back into edit mode. And go on transform mesh, then transform and select sphere, just to actually make this into a rounded shape like so. And yeah, it's coming along quite good. This is maybe going a bit too quick today, but to be honest, I think this is quite a good way of showing you how I actually do things at speed when I'm not actually explaining it slowly. Oops, I'm just moving these lines. So as you can see, I'm just shaping this down. Keep going in and out of edit mode by pressing the Tab key and go on face select. And I'm just going to move this down. Because I'm using the influence ring, I can actually grow that and just move this down, which actually affects different areas. Just subdivide that by 2 and just move it back round. Yeah, move it along the Y direction just to make that handle bend a little bit. And I'm just going to add a modifier now. It's going to be the subdivision surface modifier. I'm just seeing this just to see if it's looking quite good. And I'm just going to Control and R just to add a loop cut at the base. Move it down. Right, change that to 2. I think the handle's a bit thin, so what we're going to do is actually change the thickness of the handle just shortly. If we get rid of the subdivision modifier again, just makes it easier to actually select things. And I'm just using the influence ring just to thicken things up. And in and out of edit mode by pressing the Tab key. And I just put a subdivision on the inner ring of the handle just to actually make it look better. And then I can press the Alt key down and the left click, select that ring there and shrink it down. Same with the bottom one as well. So I'm just shrinking it down. I'm going to do the same with the bottom. Pressing the Alt key and select the ring by pressing left click. And as you can see, we're making our basic shape of our jug. Add the subdivision modifier in. Once more, set it to 2. And that's it. We've done our milk jug. Or more or less done it anyway. Looking quite good. Just put a loop cut in there. Just give it a little bit more geometry. And I'm just going to round it off by putting the transform and to sphere and just moving my mouse to actually change the shape of our jug subtly. Next, what we'll do is we'll add in a mesh, and the mesh we'll add in is a cylinder. I think it's on 32, maybe 32 is not enough to actually make our lid. We'll see. Yeah, I think I'll actually change this. So I'm just going to delete this. So, yeah, X and delete that. I'm just going to add in a a mesh, and it's going to be a cylinder again. Oopsie daisy, what's happening here? Let's just move this up. Right, start again. Adding a cylinder mesh and a cylinder. And we're going to change this to 64 vertices. It just gives it a little bit more geometry to work with. And scale this up. I'll scale it in the Z. Just to actually make it a little bit thinner. Looking from the top. Just putting this in position. And then just scale it round till it's about right. And let's scale it in the Z. Put some loop cuts in there. Oh, go on. I'm sorry. Gone in X-ray mode. So select that face. X to delete. And faces. Because we don't need that face. Control R to put a loop cut in. And just scale it up slightly. Control R, put another loop cut and put it up to this top. And just scale it up just to give it that little bit of a rounded shape. And go on face select. Take the influence ring off. Extrude. Oh, sorry, check a deselect. Then extrude. On the normals. Just to make a lid shape. Control and R top and then Control and R at the bottom just to make our basic lid shape. And I'm going to go on face select and E and S just to actually and G and Z just move it up. Just what we're doing is shaping things. E and S and E and S again, which will make so there is no distortion. Now looking at the base, I'm just going to edit mode by pressing the tab key. I'm going to select the this ring by going online select and pressing the alt key and left click and E and S to scale this down. E and Z, just move it in the up direction, and then E and S just to scale this down, and E and S one more time. I think that's about right. So we made our jug, we made our lid. So all we've got to do now is scale it down just so it's the right size and just add a little bit of colour to our milk jug. The lid I'm going to make green because the actual one that I'm copying this off, I've got the jug at the side of me, so I just got it out of the fridge. And I'm just going to go into actually rendered mode just to see what it'd look like. A little bit light, so I might make it a little bit darker in a minute and take the roughness down. No, I'll leave it because that, it does look a bit like a plastic anyway. But what I'm going to do is maybe add I'll add the velvet to it, I think, because velvet, it's got that weird look about it. So what is it? Velvet. Just change the color. There we go. Yep, quite like that. And then all we need to do is add another material to the actual jug itself or the carton. In fact, it's not quite the right shape, so I'm just going to reshape this base by actually selecting face select and selecting all the bottom faces. And I'm just going to move it. Yeah, let's move that out of the way. Right. Select the bottom faces by pressing the shift key down or the control key, whichever you wish to do. And I'm just going to G and Z just to move these in the up direction just to make my jug shape. Yeah, I think that's about right. And last but not least, let's make the actual area a bit darker. Add in a plane, scale it up. And I think the material just needs changing on the jug itself. Let's move this light. Change this to a sun. By going on the little bulb icon, change it to a sun. A bit too bright, so change it from 1000 and back to 1. That's it. And as you can see, the jug, not very shiny, so I might actually add a material into the actual jug. There we go, that's not too bad a jug. But let's just make it a little bit shinier. So add a material, new, adds whiting by default, take the metallic up, that's it. Just a little bit to make it look a bit plasticky. 0.489 and the roughness down to 0.156. And just make that a little bit brighter. And add a little bit of an emission just to get that sort of look that the milk jugs have. They seem to actually glow a little bit in the dark, if you know what I mean, but I suppose that's because they've got actual milk in them. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. This is Blender TC. Have fun making the jug. Bye for now.